Well, it's the weekend here at S&S Turbines, so once again it's time to make a video. We're inside an Afterburner. This is the Afterburner jet pipe, and straight ahead of us is the flame holder. The fuel spray bars are behind that. I'm going to back out now. This is the nozzle that changes area based on exhaust gas flow and temperature. This is what you see sticking out the back of a Starfighter or an F4 Phantom. Okay, we're inside the shop at S&S. It's the weekend, so nobody's wearing coveralls except for Walter. This is a 1500. It's an industrial engine. It's going to an American power plant. And right there is the J79 aircraft engine from which it's derived. And Walter's working on converting a J79 to a 1500. We've got a lot of the aircraft accessories are still on there. How's it going, Walter? It's going well. Back here, we've just removed the jet pipe. This is the flame holder. And you can see the ring of 21 Afterburner spray bars. They're right here. There's one. And it's called an Afterburner because the fuel is injected into the exhaust stream after the last stage of the turbine. And you can see the turbine in there, right in there. So it burns the fuel after the engine. It's an Afterburner. Here are the four individual manifolds. Each one is hooked up to a different circuit on each spray bar. These are all controlled separately, so you can have four different stages of fuel flow into the Afterburner. And then we'll just give a nice slow pan to show you how these things are put together. You'll notice that there's no large bolts. They're all quite small. The fasteners on these extremely powerful engines are quite small. This is the turbine case. The turbines are whizzing away inside there. This is the combustor outer case. The combustor liners are in there. The fuel is burnt right in here. The fuel nozzles go into these holes and they sit about there inside the combustor liners. All the fire is happening in there. And this is what we call the midframe. This is the compressor rear frame. It's very hot. Compressor front frame, all the linkages for the variable stators. And all this piping and whatnot, that's aircraft stuff. We're gonna remove all this stuff to make an LM1500 out of a J79. With the help of our talented staff, which consists of Walter.